for the session will be drug-coated balloon angioplasty and hemodialysis access. Thank you.
Thank you, dear Chairman, dear colleagues. I would like to thank the organizing committee and Professor Veith for inviting me here again this year. It's really an exceptional meeting, and I'll briefly share with you some of our experience with the application of paclitaxel-coated balloon angioplasty in order to treat failing hemodialysis access. These are my conflicts of interest, and going on, 1 out of 1,000 patients in the United States suffer from end-stage renal disease, and it is supposedly arteriovenous shunt creation is the most commonly performed vascular surgical procedure. Now, the mean patency of the vascular access ranges around 3 years. In the short term, grafts behave better than fistulas, but in the long term, fistulas perform better than AV grafts. And everybody knows this slide, the different kinds of AV access that may offer to the patients. And the main things that we need to remember is that the failing access may account for up to 20% of end-stage renal patient disease patients that are admitted in the hospitals. And today's catheter-based procedures portray around an 80% rate of recanalization success. Now, this would account to almost $1 billion, at least in the United States. Now, this is an example. This is a very nice specimen, and you can appreciate the thickness of the media and the thickness of the intima, very aggressive restenosis, very aggressive disease. Now, you might think that, for example, SFA is quite a nasty vessel, but if you have a look at that slide here, you can appreciate that although coronaries and carotids have show very low rates of restenosis, the femorals, you may expect around a 50% rate of restenosis after a couple of years, but if you have a look in the AV fistulas and AV grafts, the rates of restenosis are very, very high, up to 50% at 6 months. And this graph very nicely illustrates the cumulative primary patency rate of fistulas and grafts and how they drop very, very rapidly in the early years. Now, why is that? It's simply because veins are not arteries, and end-stage renal disease causes endothelial dysfunction. Patients suffer from uremia, there is increased oxidative stress, there is inflammation, and this actually synergistically contributes to the constrictive and negative remodeling that those vessels exhibit. Now, what would be the role of drug-coated balloons in that environment? If you have a restenosis of your vascular access, then of course this would gradually lead to a failing access. There will be a rate of thrombosis, and then of course you need to open that up, you need to have a redo procedure. You might have